ברכות ט' עמוד א', ברכות 9a, מעשה שבאו בניו. In the Mishnah, the very beginning of the ברכות, we have a long discussion, the machloke, different opinion between Rabbi Eliezer, Chachamim, and Rabban Gamliel. To refresh your memory, we discussed the time for saying Shema. Rabbi Eliezer said it's the first watch. Chachamim said Ad Chatzot, and Rabban Gamliel said until Amud HaShachar, until the dawn. And we brought the story that the Rabban Gamliel sons returned from a wedding celebration. It was, let's say, 2:30 in the morning, and it was a question of saying Shema. So the big question here is, what exactly happened with the story in the Mishnah? We said that the Torah tells us in the Shema, Beshochbecha, uveshochbecha, uvekumecha, uveshochbecha, when you lie down, there is a time that is called Zman Shchiva. Zman Shchiva meaning the time that people lie down. Now, trace your brain, imagine a picture, those days that is no electricity and people just went to sleep when it's very earlier, because the minute it's dark, maybe some people have candles, but basically it's dark. So people go to sleep when it's dark, and they wake up in those days, especially when it's the dawn. So Beshochbecha, it's basically the time that they go to sleep. That's Beshochbecha. Okay, by Rabbi Eliezer. He hold the time that people go to sleep, that what the Torah meant, uveshochbecha, when you lie down. Rabban Gamliel said that this apply to the time that as long as people are in a state of beshochbecha, that they lie down. And as long as it's dark, that's beshochbecha. So that's the dynamic between the two. Now, what about Chachamim? The sages said at Chatzot. So what's the, to what party, to which one they go by? They go by Rabbi Eliezer or go by Rabban Gamliel? So the Gemara asks, Ve'ad hashta lo shmiya lehu ad Rabban Gamliel. His son doesn't know what's going on. They don't hear the opinion of their father. Which means, is that possible that the son just came from nowhere and asked the father, what's the halacha? Can we say Shema or not? So they answer and they said, "Hachika amrele." That's what they said to the father. Rabbanan pligei ilavach v'yachid v'rabim halacha kerabim, which means they knew the opinion. So if they knew the opinion, so what exactly they have a problem? Problem is, if you have one single opinion, it's called yachid. And you have Rabim, which means the majority. You have all the sages that are the majority, which is Rabim. You have single opinion versus majority opinion. You go by the majority, right? Halacha ki Rabim. So they said, when Chachamim, when they said, just said the word Ad Chatzot, until Chatzot, for that sense, it means the middle of the night. It means specifically Ad Chatzot, Davka Ad Chatzot. And therefore, if someone says Shema when Chatzot pass, it's too late, it's unacceptable. That's the Sof Zman Chatzot. Meaning, do we go by the Rabbim, by the sages, or by the Yachid, by Rabban Gamliel? So if you tell me that Yachid v'Rabim halacha k'Rabim, which means that Rabbanan, the sages, disagree with you, so therefore we may not allow to say Shema, even you are our father, because we go by the Rabbim, we go by the sages, by the Rabbanan. And if they rule that the latest time is Ad Chatzot, specifically until Chatzot, So whatever you said, it's da'at yachid, it's one individual. Or you may say, maybe they agree with you. And therefore, what they said is, they said ad chatzot is lechatchila, that's the way it should be. But if someone didn't do ad chatzot, he can read later. I want to comment on that. One of my books I wrote, it's the Bi'uri HaKlomar Berashi. It's a book I wrote on the Shas, printed 6 times, and it's the explanation of every time Rashi used the word Keloma. In the yeshiva world, they use it very much. So here, I elaborate at length the meaning of the Rashi used Keloma, and I just share with you the key point, what's the bottom line, that they want to know what's the real difference between Rabban Gamliel and Rabbanan, that at the first glance, according to the sages, if you pass time of Chatzot, it's no longer any meaning of saying Shema. And the Tosfot 3 elaborate further on that, and I quoted him, but the key point here, if someone like the sons of Rabban Gamliel say they come at 2:30 in the morning, so it's already forbidden and you cannot read say Shema, or when you use the word Chatzot, it's just siag, it's just boundary, and if someone it was a noose, so he can still say it. So he said Odilma, the other option, Rabbanan kvatach svira lach, Rabbanan not go by Rabbi Eliezer, but they go by whom? By you, which is Rabban Gamliel. V'hadekambrei ad chatzot kedei l'archik et ha'adam min ha'avera. The only reason they use the term ad chatzot, they just want to put a boundary. But so again, let's sharpen the point to make sure that we all are on the same page. It wasn't time of electricity. The discussion of Beshoch Becha, what the Mishnah meant to say Beshoch Becha, when the Torah used the word Beshoch Becha, what does that mean? And the key point is, what did that mean, the word Chatzot? Haim, do we go by the time that it's dark, the minutes that it's dark, like Rabbi Eliezer, or by the point of Rabban Gamliel, that as long as people are staying in bed before the sun rises? They want to know the midpoint, the sages. They meant to say Ad Chatzot, meaning we go by Rabbi Eliezer, and if you pass Chatzot, it's too late. Or we go by the point of Rabban Gamliel, but we just go early to put the boundaries. That's the key point. And that's what they ask the father, which means they're aware of the father, but they want to know exactly what the Rabbanan meant. In other words, can we are now at 2:30 in the morning still say Shema or not? Amar Lehu. Rabban Gamliel responded to them and he said, and now this is make it the whole Mishnah very sharp and make it clear. Rabbanan kvati svira lehu v'chayavin atem v'hadek ha'amre ad chatzot kedei l'archik et ha'adam min ha'avera. Meaning, their father Rabban Gamliel said, here is the point. The sages go by me, which means as long as people, the majority of the people are in bed, one can say Shema. Therefore, one may say, okay, like we studied the other day, remember several pages earlier? You come at home, let's eat, let's drink, let's chat with friends, let's send emails, let's do all kind of thing, and all of a sudden the person falls asleep and forget it. So the sages want to put the boundaries. They want to that the person should. So they said that one may recite the evening Shema only until midnight in order to distance a person from a sin. It's a boundary. Clear? Okay. The next one is in the Mishnah, Rabban Gamliel elaborate, and he said, "Velo zo bilvad," and not only this the case, but they said, "Ela kol ma shamu chachamim ad chatzot," or whatever they say, just said until chatzot, it means until the morning. So there is a discussion in Achronim, what does that mean, "Velo zo bilvad," and I'm just bringing the vignette of that. Rabban Gamliel, "Mi kamar ad chatzot dektane velo zo bilvad amru." Now, does Rabban Gamliel say that the evening Shema may be recited only until midnight? That the Mishnah should teach in connection with a statement and not only? What exactly it used the word velo zo bilvad? Does that mean that it's connected to the sages or to Rabban Gamliel? It's velo zo bilvad is the statement that came from the sages or Rabban Gamliel said? What we learn until Chatzot, that we have the extension until Amud HaShachar, until dawn, when did he said it? In other words, if he elaborate on his point and he said, and not only this and furthermore, where is it? Where he said it? So the answer is, Hachika Amalu Rabban Gamliel. That's exactly what he meant to say to his children. Afilu leRabbanan deKa'amre ad Chatzot, even by the sages who said that evening Shema, you can say until midnight, Mitzvata ad Sheyale Amud HaShachar. But the mitzvah actually can be extended until you see the dawn, until the dawn rises. V'had deKa'amre ad Chatzot, again, we just put a boundary in order for people not to take advantage of the last moment for saying, because usually people like to postpone it. So now we go to the next phase in the Mishnah. In the Mishnah we continue and it said, Hekter Chalavim Ve'Evarim. There is a mitzvah to have the bring the offering, and this leftover, it's like the fat part, other extra limb that involved with the Evarim. So they said, how long you can do it? You can do it until the sunrise. Now, why it's important? Because soon you see the connection between the two. Why? They said, ve'ilu achilat psachim lo katane. Since you tell me that the Mishnah talk about the time that you can burn the fat. So we said that the whole mitzvah of burning the fat, So it's applied to all different korbanot. So now they ask a question, V'ilu achilat psachim lo katane? So how come, if you tell me that that's applied to any type of doing work until Chatzot, so Mishnah does not stay the example of eating Pesach offering with all the idea that you can do it until the dawn time. So why we don't mention Veramini? Kriyat Shema Arvit. We said that Shema is the time of the evening. Ba'alel ba'alele psachim. And the time to do Alel, it's the eve of Passover, right? That's what we're doing. There are some Sfaradim that does Alel, or some doing, but Nusach Sfarad, even, right? During the Maariv, right?
I know Sfaradim and some even.
ואכילת פסח, אין דה איטינג הפסח עוברים מצוותן עד שלי עמוד השחר. אוקיי, so they said, what do you see here? You see that all of these, the mitzvah extend until the dawn rises. So he said, "Rabbi Yosef lo kasha, Rabbi Lazar ben Azar, Rabbi Akiva." Now we need to explain that there is a machloket between Rabbi Lazar ben Azar and Rabbi Akiva. So, a few words of introduction. One of the 13 principles that we said every day from Rabbi Ishmael, it's called Gzeira Shava. Gzeira Shava, the first rule, and Adam Dan Me'atzmo, which means I cannot open the Torah and make up comparison between the two texts. Gzeira Shava meaning I take one statement in one place, another statement from another place that use the same words, and I juxtapose the two. I cannot do it individually. The only thing to do it is if I have a tradition, not me, if those rabbis have a tradition from their ancestors, so they juxtapose the two texts and they learn from that. How it's applied here? They said, okay, what is our real discussion? Eating the Passover. You eat it until Chatzot, until midnight. After Chatzot, it looks like it's too late. Now, why we don't use that in the Mishnah? So we explained that there are two different rabbis that have a different opinion in this. Who are they? One is named Rabbi Lazar ben Azariah, one is named Rabbi Akiva, the Tanya. Ve'achlu et habasar balayla hazeh. The Torah said that they should eat the Pesach offering meat on the night. Rabbi Lazar ben Azari Omer, Rabbi Lazar ben Azari said, I learned from my teachers that it's a gzera shava, it's juxtaposition. Ne'emar kan balayla hazeh. It's written here, this specific night. They use the word hazeh, in this night, this particular night. Hazeh, on this night. Ve'ne'emar le'alan. We said later that God said, Va'avarti be'eretz Mitzrayim balayla hazeh, that God said, I shall pass through the land of Egypt on this night. So you see they using the word hazeh, on this night, two times. So we learn from both, right? A gzera shava, ma le'alan ad chatzot. The same way that over there, the idea of smiting the firstborn, it's referred to night until midnight. Afkan, here also, when it's come to Passover offering, it's until midnight. Omar le Rabbi Akiva. So if that's the case, Rabbi Lazar ben Azaria, he basically said that Balaila Hazeh, it means until middle of the night, half of the Laila. So Amar le Rabbi Akiva, Valo kvar ne'emar b'chipazon. What we said, that we should eat the Pesach of offering, the instruction is that they should do it in a haste, which means Ad Sh'at Chapazon, which means until the daybreak. So what is the whole idea of doing it in the hasten when they leave the Egypt, in Ken Matalmud Lomar Balayla. So what exactly you learn from the word Balayla? Okay, so first let me read something from the Rambam. The Rambam said in Hilchot Korban Pesach, in the Sefer Korbanot, as follows. Mitzvah d'achilat ha-Pesach im d'ivrei Torah d'alot ha-Shachar. The mitzvah of eating the Passover offering from the Torah is until the dawn. אולם כדי להרחיק את האדם מן העבירה, in order to distance a person from a sin, הגבילו את אכילת הקורבן עד חצות הלילה בלבד. So we circumscribe, we limited it until midnight. So basically the halacha is according to Rabbi Akiva, and later you see it's according to Rabbi Yoshua, and the only idea at חצות, it's like the Chachamim said that we put another boundary. So here, Rabbi Akiva said that the Passover you eat only at night and not during the day. So, here is the discussion. One said, יכול יהיה נאכל קודשים ביום, תלמוד לומר בלילה. בלילה הוא נאכל ולא ביום. So, the whole idea is that you have to do it during the night, you eat the Passover and not the day. Again, there are two concepts here. One is the Egyptians force them out and they do it quick, and that was at night. The second is the reality when they left and they move out, it's already the day. Okay, so the idea here, so far it's eaten only at night and not by day. So according to Rabbi Lazar ben Azar, I understand that they're using the word hazeh specifically. In other words, Rabbi Lazar ben Azar said that you eat Pesach until Chatzot, and Rabbi Akiva said until the dawn. So the reason that it's written at night, Balayla, Rabbi Akiva said only at night and not during the day. Rabbi Lazar ben Azariah said Balayla Hazeh, the same as the Makat Bechorot, the firstborn plague. So Rabbi Lazar ben Azariah has a different meaning of the sentence. Rabbi Lazar ben Azariah, Rabbi Akiva, why he used the word Hazeh, Yisrach Lemitach Hazeh, Rabbi Akiva Hazeh Mayavidlei. What does that mean on this, using the word this? So he said, "Lemeute laila acheru de'ata," which means that that you may think that Passover applied to Kodashim Kalim. There are two different korbanot. One type of korbanot is called Kodashim Kalim. It's a light, a sacrificial offering, and it's the Kodesh Kodashim, which is very restricted. What's the real difference? סלקה דה חמינה, הועיל בפסח קודשים קלים מושלמים קודשים קלים, מה שלמים נאכלים ללילה, לשני ימים ולילה אחד, אף פסח נאכל שתי לילות במקום שני ימים, ויהיה נאכל לשני לילות ויום אחד, כמה שמע בלילה הזה, בלילה הזה הוא נאכל, ולא נאכל בלילה אחר. אוקיי, so just a word of explanation. קודשים קלים, it's something that is more light than the קודשי קודשים. קודשי קודשים, some example. Kodesh Kodashim is we slaughter it in the north, Nishchat Batzafon. which means they take the Sfona Azara, the north court of the Azara. That's the place they slaughter it. Second, you eat Nechal Zichre Kehuna. That's the place that they eat it by the Kohanim, and it's only in the Azara. That's the only place you can eat Kodshe Kodashim. Kodashim Kalim, the light Kodashim. What happened is it's much lighter, like the Thanksgiving Todah offering, like Passover offering, like Maser offering, the tithe offering. So everybody can eat it, and you can slaughter it every place you want, and you can eat it even outside of the courtyard. So you see here, what happened is, if you didn't bring the Passover on time, so it turned to be a Shlamim, which means if you slaughter Passover at the 17th of Nisan, it's already Shlamim. So the time they're slaughtering, it's at night, and the day, and the next day. So Rashi here explained, what does that mean, Balayla Hazeh? Only at this night, that's the way that Rabbi Akiva said, only at that night. Ve'no nechal b'layla acher, but it may not be eaten the other night, which means the only night of Passover. Belazar ben Azariah, milot otiru ad boker nafka, he emerged from the different pasuk that they said it should not leave until the morning, but it's written all night. Ve'Rabbi Akiva, so how now Rabbi Akiva explained that phrase of lot otiru? If one, I understand from that phrase, what does that mean until morning? Until the second morning, which means the day after Pesach, the 16th, that's the morning he applied to that. So, in other words, he takes the Gzera Shava, we said that from the two places, and he said, we learn from Loto Tiru, you should not leave until the following morning, the second day of Pesach. Rabbi Lazar ben Azariah amar lach, Rabbi Lazar ben Azariah responded to Rabbi Akiva, and he said, kol boker, boker ishonu. Every expression in the morning, it's interpreted as referring to the first morning. Now we take this machloket, this two opinion between Rabbi Lazar and Rabbi Akiva, and we show you that it's another location, it's the same. The Tanya, sham tizbach et ha-pesach ba'erev, mo'ed tzedcha me'eretz Mitzrayim. So before we go there, I just want to make sure that everyone understands it. According to Rabbi Lazar ben Azariah, the morning, the boker, is the rishon, is the first one. Meaning, Rabbi Lazar ben Azariah hold that eating Passover it's until midnight only, and Rabbi Akiva hold that until Amud HaShachar, until the dawn. That's the proper time to say. So now we have a very confusing sentence because you said here, Sham Tizbach, there you shall be slaughtering the Passover offering. Ba'erev, right? In the evening, right? In the afternoon, late afternoon. Then they said, Kevo HaShemesh, when the sun descend, which means that it's night. The one we said, Ben Arbaim, now it's already said that it's night. And then we said, Mo'el Tzeitcha, the appointed time that you departed from Egypt, which is, what is Moed Tzedcha? Until Alot HaShachar. So, what do you understand from this passage? What does that mean? What exactly, when in the world you meant to say that we need to slaughter the Passover offering? How do you read this passage? Okay? Again, there shall be slaughtering Pesach offering in the afternoon. Understand? Close to the dawn time. Close to the sunset. Then you said, when did this descend? And then you said the appointed time that you departed from Egypt. It looks like three different times. So how you read it? So Rabbi Eliezer sover ba'erev atazoveach. In the afternoon, the 14th of Nisan, you slaughter the Pesach offering. Uchevo Hashemesh ataochel. When the sun descends, you may begin to eat it. Umoed tzeitcha atasorev. And the appointed time of your departure from Egypt, which is in the morning of the 15th, you burn what's left over. Rabbi Yoshua, which means, by the way, that's a notar. The reality is, just a side point, that in the morning you cannot burn. Why? Because it's already yontel, right? And the whole din sreifa is from the morning. so just one point to elaborate on that. The Tzlach said here that all the other korbanot, the whole idea of sreifa, you learn from the Thanksgiving, from the Todah. It's called notar, what's left over. So in Pesach, you say the notar, the leftover, it's from the middle of the night, from Chatzot. and whatever left, it's until the morning. So the big point here is, if someone have the special, unique force of circumstance, and he passed the time of Chatzot, so he didn't avar alav, he didn't violate the Torah law. He did something that it's not in conjunction to Torah law, but he doesn't have the punishment with karet, the severe punishment that Torah said. Anyway, Rabbi Yoshua Omer ba'erev ata zoveach. He interpreted the sentence different, and he said, in the afternoon you slaughter the Pesach offering. Kevo Hashemesh, when the sun descends, you may eat it. Ve'ad matay ata olech ve'ochel, and until when you are continue to eat it, ad moed tzeitcha me'eretz mi'mitzrayim, until the appointed time that you departed from Egypt, which means until the morning. Okay? So, you see here, the way that they take the pasuk is two different ways. According to Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah, in the evening you zoveach. The sun is from the evening. Moed tzeitcha, the time that you burn it. And the finishing of eating, it's until Chatzot. That's Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah. Anyway, Omar Rabbi Akiva, Omar Rabbi Abba, I'm sorry, Omar Rabbi Abba, Akol Modin, שנגלו ישראל מצרים ונגלו אלה בערב. So I heard from the stipler, from the Kilot Yaakov, he said that you have, during the Agada, we said the Maisa in Bnei Brak, that the rabbis were sitting in Bnei Brak, and they mesaper, and they tell the story of Egypt all night. All right? So here we just learned that the proper time to do all the offering, it's at Chatzot, until midnight, and usually the time that you eat, you say the story of Egypt. So he said, how come they said until the dawn? So he explained beautifully, and he says, all these name of rabbis, they go by the rabbi of the city. And who is the rabbi of Bnei Brak? The Mora de Atro was Rabbi Akiva. So since he was the Mora de Atro, and he hold what Rabbi Akiva hold, that until Yale Amud HaShachar, until the dawn. So the finish eating, the stipler said, is until Chatzot. I have the privilege to meet him several times. And I can't tell you how depth I learned from him. Anyway, so he explained, Achila, the time to eat, it's until midnight. But to tell the story, the supper is according to the Mar de Atra, which is Rabbi Akiva. So here, Amar Rabbi Abba, Akol Modim, Shingalu Yisrael Mitzrayim, Nugalu Ela Ba'ere. Rabbi Abba said that physically, Bepoal, they left. But when they all agree that when the Israelites were redeemed from Egypt, they were redeemed at any time other than the evening, which means at night. שנאמר, הוציאך השם לוקחה מצרים לילה, that Hashem, your God, took you out of Egypt at night. וכשיצאו, לא יצאו אליו היום, but when they physically left, it's during the day. So שנאמר, ממוחרת הפסח, יצאו בני ישראל מצרים ביד רמה. And the moral of the Passover, the children of Israel went forth upright. And al manechelku, what is the really the machloket between Rabbi Akiva and Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah? Al shat achipazon, what is exactly the time of the haste? Which means Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah savar mai chipazon, chipazon de Mitzrayim, Rabbi Akiva savar mai chipazon, chipazon de Yisrael. Which means the real difference between the two is Rabbi Elazar ben Azariah said that the Egyptians are the people who have forced them. And therefore, the time of Korban Pesach is until Chatzot. Rabbi Akiva said, no, Israel, the children of Israel, was there in haste to leave. And therefore, the time is until Amud HaShachar. Tanya Lama Yachi. This is also taught in the Braita. Utsiacha Shem Melokecha Mitzrayim Laila. The Almighty took you out of Mitzrayim at night. V'chi Balayla Yatsu, V'lo Yatsu Ela Bayom. If you read carefully the story, they left. When did they left? They left Egypt by day. Shenemar, it's written, Mimochorat ha-Pesach, from the morning of the Pesach, Yatzu bnei Yisrael b'yad ramah, the children of Israel left with upraised hand. So what does that mean, Laila? Ela melamed shi'chil alayhem ha-geula mi-ba'erev. That the beginning of the geula, the beginning of the redemption, started from the evening, which means after the midnight, the Egyptians forced them to leave. Yeah. So, if you remember when we studied the book of Ruth, we have there in chapter 3 when the Ruth came to Boaz and she asked him to redeem her. So he told her, Lini po halayla. And you can read in one of my books, Rootstock, I go at length to bring a lot of sources. What does that mean, Lini po halayla, the long lamed? Which means that it's applied to galut, to implication of the dark time, that Lini po halayla, that it's a long time of galut that is dark. And then, V'haya b'boker, in the boker, which is applied to the nation of Israel, the time of redemption, Im igalech tov, if it will happen naturally that you will be redeemed, either tov is the name of person or it's naturally redemption, fine. If not, anochi egalech, anochi is anochi Hashem lokecha, that's the promise that Hashem will be with us. So that's, it means that you see at the most worst time of darkness, beginning of geula, that's the beginning of getting out. So they said here, Daber na bozne ha'am, that Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, Daber na bozne ha'am, please speak to the ear of people, and each one of them ask his fellow, borrow for men, for women, from women, from their fellow, silver vessels and gold vessels. Amar devei anai, enai lashon bakasha, it means please. It's like appeal, the begging. Amar lehem HaKadosh Baruch Hu Moshe, God said to Moshe Rabbeinu, Bevakasha mimcha, I plead of you, lech ve'emor lahem l'Israel, go and say to a nation of Israel, Bevakasha mimchem, I plead to you, Sha'alu mimitzrayim klei kesef chezav, request from the Egyptian silver vessel and gold vessels. Why? Shelo yomar oto tzadik, that Abraham will not say, the righteous one, Va'avadum v'inu otam kiyem ba'em, that what God did said in the covenant brit ben abtarim, that they should be slave, and inu otam, that he fulfilled, ve'acharechen yitzu b'chush gadol, another promise that God made, that they live with a great wealth, he did not fulfill. Okay, so again, the big question here is why do they care if Abraham, what they said, and if Abraham did not say that God did not fulfill what he promised, what exactly it means? So there are several things. First is the idea that when they left Egypt, they didn't want to carry all this heavy loaded. If you see later, we study in the Gemara in the Sanhedrin that it was every person have tremendous amount of donkeys, etc. It was a tremendous wealth. People don't want to schlep that, crossing the Red Sea, go to the desert. They don't want to schlep all these things from them. So they said in a Song of Songs, Torei Zahav e'eselach im nekudot ha'kesef. Torei Zahav, the rabbi said, it's what gold left, it's what left of, from the sea. Nekudot ha'kesef is a small point of kesef, of silver, is the little bit that they left in Egypt, which means it's against the will. Why? Because they basically said, we don't want to get out. Number one, some of them wants to stay there. Others who are not happy, they want just to leave right away. So here we have several things that's not clear. One, what does that mean Abraham said? That the righteous one Abraham should not say, Va'avadum, God fulfilled, considered the decree that the covenant, V'acharecha yitzu b'chushadon, then they live in great wealth, he did not fulfill. So God told Abraham that they should be in Egypt for 400 years. If you count the years that they are in Egypt, how long? 210 years, correct? So the famous common interpretation, you go by the time that Hashem talked to him. But we know that God fulfilled his promise even at Al-Tnai, even it was conditional. So here is the Va'avadum, that they should enslave, Abraham agreed. Ve'inu, the time that there should be a physical slavery, which about 8 years, that would not agree. So that's the idea, Va'avadum ve'inu otam, that they should be enslaved. We agree, but Abraham, in a sense, is watching from Gan Eden Elyon, from the heaven watch, and see what happened. Amru lo ulevai shenitze ba'atzmeinu. And they said, we don't just want to go free. We don't want all of that. Mashal le'adam she'ach havush be'bet ha'asurim v'ayimu lo, v'na'adam mo'tzim utcha le'machar be'bet ha'asurim lo'tim lecha mamon arbe. If someone is in jail, and someone said to him, okay, I'm giving you a large amount of money, and I'll take you, you know, tomorrow in a couple of days you'll be out. what a normal person, the right mindset. Don't bring me any money and keep me in jail. Just let me out of jail and forget about money. Right? ואומר להם, בבקשה מכם, הוציאוני היום. I beg of you, take me out of prison today. Like the children of Israel wants to be out of Egypt right now. ואיני מבקש כלום. The Jewish people said, we don't want anything. We are out of slavery. We don't want all this wealth. We live out this all this wealth. So in other words, either you say that they are few that stay, but the majority of the people just want to be out without money, or you say that Abraham is watching over how the fulfillment happened. So vayash ilum. So they said that they should lend them. Amar Rabbi Arni melamed sheish ilum be'al korcham. So in one hand you say that they ask. So so the point is, you just want to say, to understand what we said so far, that the reason that God quote unquote begged them, it's because they didn't want to bother with all this wealth. Now we say that the vayash ilum, that they lend them, but it was against their will. Eka de amri. There are two ways to understand it. One is be'al korcham de Mitzrayim, that the Egyptians didn't want to give them, but they indirect have a pressure and force them against their will. Ve'ikad amar be'al korcham de Israel, or he said that it's against the wishes of Am Israel. How? Man de'amar be'al korcham de Mitzrayim dechtibu nuvat bayit dechalek shalal. They said, and dweller within their portion's body. What does that mean? So they said, this is from the book of Psalms 68. They said, why we need to schlep it in the desert? We don't want all of that. So that's the idea, that children of Israel doesn't want to carry it. So again, I'm sorry, Mishum Masui means that they don't want to extra burden the children of Israel. And the other, it said, Unvad Bayit Echalek Shalal, because the Egyptians knew that it's not really borrowing, but basically they're not going to get it back. Originally they took us and enslaved us, and they took everything from us. And then we took back some, little bit, right? So the Egyptian, even we asked them, we want to borrow, they knew that it's not going to come back. So one point is that the Egyptian gave, even they knew it's not really borrowing. Or you go by the other way, that the Israelite doesn't want it because they don't want the burden to carry it in the desert. Vaynatzlu et Mitzrayim, and they empty Egypt. Amar Rabbi Ami melamen she'asau akim tzuda she'en badagim. Rabbi Ami, they said that they make Egypt in a trap, in metzuda, that contain no grain. Vereish Lakish amar asu akim tzula, with lamed, not with dalet, she'en badagim, they transform Egypt into an equivalent to the depth of Metzula of the sea, that there is no fish. Rashi here again say Kilomara, again refer you to my book, so I just give you the idea that the idea of Metzula, there is no food left. So there is a point that the Arizal said, or Achaim brought it to, that the whole purpose of children of Israel for being in Galus, being in exile, it's in order to bring all kind of neshames, all kind of souls that scatter around the world and wants to bring them back, like the story of Ruth. The reason we have the story of Ruth is that David HaMelech, the King David, came from that soul. So the minutes we gather all these neshamot, we have no reason to stay there. So we complete the task we have to do and we go on. So that's the idea of Metzula She'en Badagim, which means that they equivalent to the depth of the sea where there's no fish. So it means that they reach a point that is nothing left. What does that mean, nothing left? They did, according to Arizal or Chaim HaKadosh in particular, elaborate on that. We brought all these neshamot, all these souls, sparks of souls and people that became part of us. And the minute that mission completed, there is no cause, there's no reason. They empty the land, they empty the neshamot they need to do before the end of the days. Next, that's the response that God said to Moshe Rabbeinu when he was in doubt how to speak to Pharaoh. Hashem said, I shall be where I shall be. Omar lo HaKadosh Baruch Hu LeMoshe, the Holy One blesses, he said to Moshe Rabbeinu, Lechem Ho Leirem Yisrael, Ani Emachem B'Shiabud Zeh, V'Ani Emachem B'Shiabud Malchuyot. So God said to Moshe Rabbeinu, go and speak to Pharaoh. And he said to him, I'll be here with you now. And since Moshe Rabbeinu is also a prophet of the prophets, said that I'll be with you in the future, all these four kingdoms subjugated you. All this future subjugation, I'll be with you. אמר לו לפניו, ריבונו של עולם, משה said to God, Master of the universe, דיה לצרה בשעתה. It's not enough that they have so much sorrow here in Egypt. They need to hear that it's in the future is going to be more sorrow. Why do we have to continue and tell them sorrow or sadness? אמר לו הקדוש ברוך הוא, so God responded to him and he said, לכם עולם, יש לכן ילכם. Go and tell them, I shall be sent to you. Which means the name of God alludes only to the present situation. Only now and not the exile. Okay, so that's the name of God. It's have a double, use the word Aleph, Hey, Yud, Hey, name of God twice. So since we mentioned that, we mentioned, by the way, another thing that replied to a repetition of the word with the same connotation. He said, Aneini Hashem Aneini. When Eliyahu approached Hashem, when he went to the Mount Carmel and he was against all these false prophets, so he asked God for help. So he said, Answer me Hashem, answer me. Omar Rabbi Abaul Amar Amar Eliyahu Aneini Shtei Pe'amim. Why Eliyahu repeats itself, Aneini Hashem Aneini. That's one of the poems that we said during Selichos. We quote from Eliyahu Anavi what he said, Aneini Hashem Aneini. Answer me Hashem, answer me. מלמד שאמר אליהו לפני הקדוש ברוך הוא, that's teacher us, that אליהו said before, ריבונו של העולם, master of the universe, ענני שתרד אש מן השמיים ותאכל את כל אשר על המזבח, answer me, that the fire shall come from heaven, and consume all the altars that he prepared against all the others, in התנ"ך, וענני שתשיח דעתם, כבר שלום גומה שכשפים, and the second request is, that they should not say that I'm doing here some magic, so you should not say that it's a witchcraft, a magic, שנאמר, ואתה הסיבותה את ליבם אחורנית, and that you should turn their hearts back. So in that sense, it's a very similar. Moshe Rabbeinu, they always, Pharaoh, every time he would show Pharaoh some sign, Pharaoh said, it's masik shofim, it's a witchcraft, I can show you my people that they do the same. So here, in the sense of juxtaposition, we say the same idea, Eliyahu, he's supposed to do everything, it's a Mizbeach, his altar in Jerusalem, he should do it in Yerushalayim. Why go to Mount Carmel? It's all Hurat Shah, it's this force of circumstance, he needs to do it. So he asked the same way as Moshe Rabbeinu asked. He says, first of all, I want you to make sure that the fire comes, even if it's not Yerushalayim, here in Mount Carmel, and consume it. And second, that all of them in their mindset and heart should not say that I'm creating here some type of witchcraft. Mishnah. Mematai kurin eshma beshacharit, from when we recite the Shema in the morning, mishiyakir ben tchelel elavan, when a person recognizes the difference between the white wool and the blue wool. Rabbi Eliezer omer ben tchelel karti, he said, it's a little fellow, remember, it's before the time of electricity, between the blue wool and the wool dye in the color of leek. So that's the, so again, Beshoch Becha, when you lie down. Now with the next Mishnah talk about Uvkumecha, when you arises. So the first one is between the white wool and the blue wool. The second one is between the blue wool and the wool dye of color of leek, which means it's a little longer when you have a natural Teurativ Eat, a natural lightning. Then, וגומרה, and when how long you read Shema, until עד הנצח חמה, until sunrise. רבי יהושע אומר עד 3 שעות, he said until 3 hours, שכן דרך מלאכים לעמוד ב3 שעות, because the custom of kings to rise from the bed with the passage of about 3 hours, because they are spoils. It's not like usual people in those days, they rise whenever it's the dawn, the sunrise, that's natural, בקומך. He said, until 3 hours, that's the spoiled kings, they do it for 3 hours. הקורא מכאן ואילך לא יפסיד כאדם הקורא בתורה. If someone come over to synagogue, or he woke up later, and he said, oh, I already passed the time. So they said, no, you should say it, But the fulfillment is not the same category. It's just like someone who reads from the Torah, but it's also an obligatory. In other words, if there are situations, a person wake up after the 3 hours, he still have the obligation to say Shema, but it's considering as someone who's reading the Torah, it's recite Shema, is not get the reward of mitzvah of Shema the same way, but it's the Rashi explained here, it's still reward for saying the word of the Torah. And if you want, you can read further. Rabbeinu Yonah have a long explanation in elaboration of this Rashi. My ben chel levan, the Gemara asks, what's the mean from the one can distinguish between blue one and the white wool? Ilema gevava de amra chivara le gevava de amra dit chelta. If you said a different between bundle of white wool and bundle of the blue wool, habelele name madeade. There is some situation that even at night you know the differentiate between them, this color. Ela ben chelak sheba le shaban sheba. Even within the color, between the blue wool and the bundle of the white wool, which means that it's a little later. Tanya, Rab Meir Omer b'shiakir ben ze'ev lechelen. The proper time is at night. It's hard to distinguish between the wolf and the dog. When I was in service, we have some Bedouin that they can see at night the borders and recognize even a cat that crossed the border. So it's a usually people need to see more light to distinguish between the wolf and the dog. Rabbi Akiva Omer ben chamor le'arod, between the donkey and the wild donkey, which is again, you need more time. V'acharim omrim acharim, it's Elisha ben Avuya that became Acher, so they don't quote his name because he ends up inappropriately, but that's the acharim. Mishiret chaviro rachok abamot v'yakirenu. When you see a friend from about abamot, which is a 2 meter side, and recognize him, that's already time to say Shema. Amar Ravuna alacha k'acharim. Ravuna said it's alacha according to Elisha ben Avuya, the acharim. Amar Abaye litfilin k'acharim. Abaye hold that to put a feeling, that's according to acharim. לקריאת שמע כוותיקין, the time to recite שמע is the ותיקין, the earliest time, which is the time that the הנץ, the very beginning. אמר רבי יוחנן, ותיקין הגוברים אתן לנצח אמר, you see those מיניונים that have ותיקין, עד הנצח אמר, that the sign that the very beginning of the dawn, that's they call ותיקין, the very earlier one, the earliest time in המערכת, ותיקין הגוברים אותן לנצח אמר, כדי שסמור גאול על תפילה ונצפה ביום. So it means that in order to attach the Geula, Baruch Ata Hashem Gal Yisrael, the redemption to Tefillah, which is the Amida. So therefore, you do it in a proper time, so they start the davening, and then they length the Shema and wait. In our days, you can watch the exact second, when is the time of the Hanetz, and then you attach, you make the Geula and the Tefillah together as one unit. Amar Abzeir, Amai Krai, Ruach HaNisham, Yishlifnei Reach Dodorim. What does that mean? The Pasuk that King David said, they shall fear with you the rising of the sun, and before the moon come, the generation from generation. What is the Pasuk in the Psalm means? Heid Rabbi Yoshua ben Lakim Shum Kala Kedish Yerushalayim. That's the name of Rabbi that he said in the congregation, Holy Congregation Yerushalayim. Kol Asomer Gula Al-Tfilah Nonizok Kol Ayom Kulo. Someone who attached and followed this instruction, put the redemption, Geula, Baruch Ata Hashem Gal Yisrael, to Tefillah, to the Amidah, he has a good day. He's not ever before Raham before him all day. Omar Rab Zera Eini, is that true? Va'ana Samchei Vitazkei, I did it and I was damaged. Amar Lei B'mai Tazakt, says what the harm befallen you? He said, Amtiat Asale V'melka. They ask him something that is not really a great honor, to bring a martyr to the house of king, which means to be one of the delegation to do bring a martyr to the house of king. Hatanami Mibayach Lemivarak Lemech Ze'apra De Malka. For in that case, you should even be required to offer payments to see the face of the king. So it's something good. Why you take it negatively? The Amar Rabbi Yochanan, Lulam Yishlel Adam Larus Likrat Malchei Yisrael, Velo Likrat Malchei Yisrael Bilvad, Ela Afilu Likrat Malchei Over Kochavim. Person should run to greet all this king, not only Israel king, but all the other kings. Sheim Yizkeh, because if one is married, to behold the days that the end of the days, Mashiach's time, the world to come, Yavchin Malchei Yisrael Malchei Over Kochavim. He distinguished between the two different kings. Amal Rav Ila Leula, Ki Ailat Leatam, when we go to Eretz Yisrael, Shail Bishlamad Rabbuna Achi B'Mamad Kol HaChavura. The Adam Gadolu V'Samech Mitzvot. He said that when you go to there, you greet my brother Ravuna in the presence of the entire. Why? Because he's a great man who rejoiced to perform with Mitzvot. Why? Zimna Chada Samach Gula Tfilah. Because once he rejoined the redemption, a blessing, Gal Israel, to a prayer of sunrise, and he was so happy that the smile not leave his lips all day. And we say always that it's very important to smile, not only for that time, but all day long. As I ask, how come you do it? Because usually you say a line before the beginning of the Shmoneh Esrei, because the Amida, Hashem Sfadai Tiftach Ufi Yagiladecha, Vamar B'Yochanan, Batchila Omer Hashem Sfadai Tiftach, please Hashem open my mouth, Vosof Omer Yul Ratzon Im Refi, and at the end we said, may it will be this one, and find mouth in your favor, Amar B'Lazar, Teher B'Tfilah Shel Arvi, that should be in the evening prayer, Vamar B'Yochanan, Ezeu Ben HaOlam Haba, Zeu HaSomer Gula Shel Arvi, Tfilah Shel Arvi, that one who attach the Geula, the redemption of Maariv with the prayer of Maariv, which is the Amida. El Amar Rabbi Lazar, Teh B'Tfilat HaMincha. If you pay attention B'Tfilat HaMincha, we add another line, which is Kishem Hashem Ekra. So here he said, Rabbi Yochan ruling that maybe the prayer of Mincha, Maravashi, El Afilu Teh Ma'akulu, it's all of the three. Ela V'Kevan V'Kevur Rabbanan B'Tfilah, because the rabbis institute the recitation of this verse in the prayer, K'Tfilah Arich Tadami. It's like one long prayer, and it's basically considering an attachment. Ilo Teh Ma'achi, if you don't say so, so in the evening, how can you attach the redemption of the blessing of prayer to join the Amida? We need to say after Gal Israel, Hashem Elokeinu Shalom, please help us to lay down in peace. Ela kevan detakinu rabbanan Hashkivenu, because the sages institute the prayer of Hashkivenu, lay us down. Ki geula arich tadam, it's like length of exile. Achaname kevan dekavu rabbanan tefillah, because the rabbis instituted the recitation with the prayer, Kitfila Arichtadam. It's considering as a long prayer, so it's not, it does not constitute the interruption between the redemption and the prayer. Michdei Hayul Ratzonim Refi. So why we said at the end of the Shmoneh Esrei, the Amida, may the expression of my mouth find favor. Mashma Levasov. Mashma Meikar Debaina Lemeimar. Maitama Letakun Rabbanan Lachar Shmoneh Esrei Brachot. Why the sages put it at the end? Leekro Meikara, that they should recite the beginning of the 18 blessing. Amar Rabbi Yehuda b'Rebbe Rabbi Shimon ben Pazi, Hoil velo Amaro David el Lachar Shmoneh Esrei Parshiyot, because King David said this, he pronounced this verse until after the first composition of the 18 chapters of Shmoneh Esrei. Lefichach takinu, in other words, he composed it after the 18 psalms. Lefichach takinu rabbanan, therefore the sages established it leachar Shmoneh Esrei brachot, after the 18 brachot. Hane Shmoneh Esrei Tsha Esrei Avyam. If you look at the Devil Machining, you see that it's basically 19. The answer, Ashrei Ish v'lama rgshu goyim chad haparshiyai. Okay, so if you first is about the Tehillim. Tehillim, you look at the Psalm, it's 19. So it said Ashrei Ish, the beginning, praiseworthy the person. And Lama Ragshu, the second one, it's considering it's one parsha, it's one long chapter. The Amar Rabbi Yehuda, Rabbi Yehuda, Rabbi Shimon ben Pazi, 103 parashiyot Amar David, velo Amar Hallelujah ad shirab matav shloshim. He doesn't say praiseworthy until he see the downfall of the wicked. Shenemar yitamu chataim min haaretz, the sinner sees from the earth, ureshaim odinam, and the wicked should be no more. Barachin nafshi Hashem al Elukah. So blessed be the soul, bless Hashem al Elukah. So it's basically, we also derive from that we never pray for the destruction of the evil. We ask them yitamu chataim min haaretz, that they should make teshuva and change the way. Hanemea v'shalosh Hane 103, 104, and it's actually divided into the 104 chapter. Elashma mina ha'ashra'ish v'lama ragshu goyim chad parashayayi. That Ashra'ish, the first psalm, and lama ragshu is one. Amar Rabbi Shmuel bar Nachmani, Amar Rabbi Yochanan, kol parasha shayta chaviva al David, patach ba be'ashra, v'siyem ba be'ashra. Every thing that David loved, he beginning with the word praiseworthy and he finished with praiseworthy. Patach be'ashra dichtiv Ashrei Ha'ish, he beginning the Psalms with Ashrei Ha'ish, praiseworthy in the man. V'siyem be'ashra l'asri Ashrei kol chosei bo. That's the end of chapter 2 in the book of Psalms. La 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 la